Hey guys, this is StuMurray47 here, back with another Superman-related statue review. Today I'm going to be looking at a stunning piece in my collection. This is the half-scale Superman bust sculpted by Simon Devantes of Garage Studios. It is of course based on the artwork of Jim Lee, and in my opinion does a fantastic job of recreating Jim's artwork in three dimensions. Now, when I first saw images of this bust online, I really had no idea who sculpted it at all, to be honest. But no matter what, I knew I'd always love to own it someday. It wasn't until I actually saw the sculptor Simon posting in some statue forums online that I realised he was actually the guy who sculpted it, and I made contact with him. I really cannot praise Simon enough on the originality of his designs and just how awesome all his end products look. He was definitely more than happy to help me increase my collection, and anyone that follows the custom garage built statue world will no doubt recognise some of Simon's work. I do want to stress that this is not the only statue that I received from Simon recently, and whilst I'm dying to share pictures, I really want to film a full review and properly show off what else he sent me. It definitely deserves it. Stunning and huge are the two most appropriate words I can use. Watch this space. As I mentioned earlier, the likeness for the bust is taken straight from the art of Jim Lee. Anyone who knows me knows I love Jim Lee's artwork. His take on Superman is so classic that he'll always be in my top 5 artists. Whilst I've not really read everything that Jim Lee has worked on, books such as Batman Hush, Superman for Tomorrow, Superman Unchained, and his artwork for the start of the new 52 Justice League book are all must-reads in my opinion. If you've not read them, then get to your local comic book store stat. Even if you don't like all the stories, the art definitely sucks you in and keeps you engrossed throughout, at least it does for me anyway. Strong poses and dynamic action always go hand in hand with his artwork. Now, here you can see the actual image that Simon used as reference for the statue. Superman looks really serious, and that scowl on his face says volumes. I want you to pay close attention to all the lines in the face and the neck, the angle of the head, and of course those crazy spiked windswept hair strands. These are all aspects that Simon managed to faithfully recreate perfectly, as well as the vibrant colours of Jim Lee's Superman suit. There's something so distinctive about the Jim Lee Superman S. The instant I see it, I know that he drew it. Okay, so here's the point you've all been waiting for, getting to see this bad boy in more detail, and to be honest, I don't think you're going to be disappointed, because I definitely wasn't. Now, seeing the bust rotate, you instantly get an appreciation for how well it's made. The way the front torso ends exactly on the line of the S-shield is inspired, and it really reminds me of the 1-to-1 scale Sideshow Superman bust that was released recently. I love the way that the base echoes classic architectural designs. It really gives off that Metropolis vibe and reminds me of the top or the main central spire of the Empire State Building. It does include the classic Superman logo, of course, but I'll show you that in more detail later. Now, what really sells this piece, as I mentioned before, Simon nailed the sculpt here. It looks so realistic. Now, from the creases in the suit, to individual pores on the face, to that amazing hair, the fact that the hair is windswept off the head is my favourite aspect. It was also one of my big worries when it was shipping, but thankfully Simon and his team wrapped everything up perfectly, so, you know, I didn't spare any expense getting this to me in one piece. Hell, even the S-curl is raised up off the forehead. It's a separate piece which once again lends itself to the realism. I even like the way that the back of the piece isn't perfectly lined up at the shoulders. You can see that one side is ever so slightly raised. Now that is accurate to the artwork, so I do appreciate he's taken that care and time to do it. It doesn't sit perfectly flush with the base when looking at it straight on at the back, but it's not meant to. Now, one of the things that stands out on this piece, which I'm sure you've seen, is the paintwork. There is so much shading throughout the skin, the suit, the cape, the eyes are piercing blue, the hair has a beautiful wet look to it, and I believe that Simon's son actually does a lot of this, so kudos to him because he does a great job. Now, here's a close-up on the base itself, and you can see that fantastic classic Superman logo. Obviously, it's got that nice curved look to it. It's almost like it's came right off the front of a comic book. I have seen variants of this whereby Simon has painted the Superman writing in yellow, which obviously would make it stand out a lot more, but I'm glad that mine's is in the darker black that sort of blends into the base. Now, as you look at the bottom of the base, you do get to see Simon's signature there. So Simon does kind of sign these in, it's scribed in there, and you can see the Garage Statues logo, so I do like that personal touch there. Obviously it has the stopper stands on the four corners to stop this thing from sliding about. It has to be said, there isn't really a bad angle you can look at this piece from. As you can see from this down angle, you know, he still has that frown, that intensity, but obviously the S-shield is right in your face. You know, that's one of the things I really love about this, is how pronounced the S-shield is. It's all sculpted, it's not just lines on there, it's all raised. Looking at the head in more detail, and I hope you appreciate the sheer amount of work that's gone into this. You can see individual pores going down, you know, the cheeks up onto the forehead, the frown lines, the creases in the eyes. Everything is sort of sculpted to perfection, and it really does give off that realistic vibe. Looking at the eyes, and yet again, they're piercing blue, they're so well painted, and in person, it might not show in these images, but it does have a glassy look, you know, so when you're moving around it, they really have that realistic look to them. Focusing in more on the hair, and yet again, this windswept look doesn't disappoint. You can see here there's so many individual strands coming off the head here. I am counting my lucky stars that this thing arrived in one piece. However, it's no accident. As I mentioned before, Simon and his team did a great job of packaging this. The head was totally separate. You know, when I say separate, it wasn't detached or anything, but there was no packaging wrapped around it that could have easily pierced or broke any of the individual hairs. It was, you know, very, very finely packaged to ensure that this arrived in one piece. Now, from a top view, you can see yet again the vibrancy of the colours here. The cape isn't just one shade of red. There's deep shading going through all the creases. There's blue shading in all the creases on the front of the suit. The sheer amount of detail can't be sort of quantified. It's amazing. No more so than here on the back of the head. Now, obviously, with a lot of hair sculpts I've seen in the past, sometimes it can be just several strands, but in this case, you're looking at hundreds and hundreds of individually sculpted strands, and I love the way that even through the casting and the moulding process, none of that detail was lost whatsoever. It looks like real hair. It's painted well, it's glossy, it's shiny, it's just brilliant. And just a final sort of look at the front of the figure, it has a really nice sheen to it, so that in person, when you're walking around it and looking at it, it really does look real. Closing in on the base a bit more, and one of the interesting details I like is the Superman S-Shield Pentagon that you can see all the way around the base there. There's three of them in total, sort of on both sides and one at the back. Moving up, you can see the sculpting detail that's gone into not only the base, but just, I want to give you a sort of a handheld look at the head here. Here you can see the S-curl is sort of pronounced and raised off the forehead. It is attached, of course, but you can tell it's a separate piece, and little details like that make this piece. Now, moving on to scale, and this is a section which might split a few collectors. Now, there are a lot of people out there who really want to own one-to-one scale pieces, obviously being full-size busts. Now, this one, as I mentioned before, is half scale. It's approximately 17.75 inches tall. Now, as a result, you know, the good thing about it is it doesn't take up anywhere near as much space as our full-size bust, but it looks equally as cool. Now, that's why I like it. Space is always at a premium in my collection, and even though I have a massive statue collection, I do want to make sure I can display as much of it as possible. And I really don't have enough room to have, you know, 20 full-size busts, so a nice half-size bust like this is perfect for me. Now, as you can see in scale to the 17.75 inch tall bust, I always show off my DC Collectibles New 52 Trinity War Superman figure. Now, that one measures approximately 6.5 inches tall, and of course on the other side you see a regular old can of Coke, which is about 4.75 inches. Just to give you a rough idea of how big this is, of course, and how much space it would take up in your collection. Me personally, I'm glad it's smaller. If you would like to see how big it would be next to a full-size bust, here it is next to my Alex Ross full-size bust, or Alex Ross inspired bust. An absolutely stunning piece as well, and I think you'll agree they both look really good together. This isn't exactly the way I've got them displayed, but for the purposes of this review, I just wanted to show them both off for scale. Now, I also want to point out that Simon doesn't just make this statue in one particular style or medium, he will actually make it to order, so if you want it to look like rock or granite, he will be quite happy to do so, and as you can see from these images, the end result looks stunning. I can't imagine anyone that wouldn't want one of these statues sitting on top of like a marble column or something. You know, it looks so great, it would even look great in a garden. But not only that, but one of his previous buyers, John Allred, I believe, he's a very good painter, and he bought one unpainted painted and created this, a beautiful black onyx metallic looking Superman. It just looks stunning. You know, the amount of options with a sculpt are endless. To that point, Simon also creates a cyborg Superman version, if you're interested. The skin is torn away, the glowing eye is exposed. It's almost, you know, obviously a bit like a Terminator. And as I said, whether you want it rocky looking, regular Terminator, even if you want it with a black suit and a red S, he'll make that for you. You know, there's so many variants and alternatives. You know, if you want more blue in the hair, he'd be quite happy to do that. I've had obviously a lot of dealings with him recently, and I cannot wait to share with you guys the statue that I have coming. We've worked together and he's created some unique pieces for it. I cannot wait to share it. But as I said, some of these alternate versions that I'm showing in images here are stunning and would look great, especially in a dimly lit room with that glowing eye. So very, very awesome. Now, the last thing I'd like to show comparison-wise is the base image compared to the statue itself. And I think you'll agree he nailed it. Be it the S-curl, the hair, the suit, you know, the lines going up the neck, even the shape of the mouth. There isn't an aspect of this that doesn't echo the original artwork. And, you know, to see these side by side, I don't think anyone can deny that he's done a fantastic job. So, closing thoughts, guys. Do I like it? I think you can probably guess I do. Do I recommend it? Yes, I do as well. With regards to cost, that would obviously have to be discussed with Simon. These things vary, of course. What I would recommend doing, I'm going to include a link to Simon's Facebook page in the description. So if you are interested in getting one of these, or you're interested in any of his other pieces, then by all means, you know, click on the link, go to his Facebook page. I don't think you'll be disappointed. I am so very tempted to include images of the next statue, as I said before, but I'm not. I'm going to save it for my review, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So once again, thanks, guys. I hope you've enjoyed the review. It's been really fun looking at this in close detail. I am so, so lucky to have it in my collection and be able to look over and admire it all day. This was, of course, Stu Murray 47. If you enjoyed the video, please rate, comment, subscribe. I really do read all your comments. I try to respond to them as quick as I can. I've been a bit better recently trying to catch up, but if you could drop a comment, drop a like, I would really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys all in the next review. So thanks for watching. See you next time.